In 1981, Xerox introduced the Star office information system. The radical user interface of Star had a major impact on the office system and personal computer industry. Star introduced the use of icons to represent objects and applications. The desktop metaphor, with a direct manipulation interface, windows containing multimedia documents, property and option sheets, and generic commands. In some ways, such as its use of the move, copy, and delete functions, Star remains unsurpassed in the consistency of its interface. Other features, such as multilingual, multimedia documents, have only recently appeared in other systems. The following videotape was made in 1982 by two Star designers, David Canfield Smith and Charles Irby. It illustrates some of the innovations in computer-human interfaces embodied in the Xerox Star.
I'm David Smith. I'd like to introduce you to the Xerox 8010 Star Information System. This is a new computer designed for office professionals. It consists of a processor, a large display screen, a keyboard, and a pointing device called the mouse. Stars are normally connected together by the Ethernet local area network. This not only allows stars to communicate with one another, but it also lets them share resources, such as file storage and printers. The mouse has a ball on the bottom that rotates as the mouse slides across a flat surface. This moves a cursor on the screen in corresponding motions. It has two buttons on top that can be sensed under program control. You can use these buttons to specify objects and destinations for commands. The keyboard consists of a standard typing array and three groups of function keys. The left group contains the generic functions, delete, copy, move, and show properties. These four are used throughout the system. For example, you use the same function key, move, to move a character in text, a line in an illustration, a fraction in an equation, or a document in a file drawer. The top group of keys consists of common text formatting functions, making text bold, italic, underlined, super or subscripted, or in a larger or smaller font. The right group of keys consists of miscellaneous functions for getting online assistance, defining and expanding abbreviations, stopping ongoing operations, and others. The display screen shows your working environment. We call this the desktop. It is an electronic analog for an office. On the screens are small pictures or icons representing familiar office objects. This turned black because I pointed to it with the mouse and clicked the mouse button. We call this selecting the object. Selected objects highlight in reverse video. You can then operate on the selection with the delete, copy, move keys, and other keys. Let me select some of the other icons on the desktop. This is a folder, a records file, a file drawer, 3270 and teletype terminals, printers, and in and out mail baskets. Using the move key, you can arrange your desktop in any way you like. Move is the most powerful command in the system. It replaces a large number of conventional computer commands, which we will point out as we go along. The copy command is also a powerful one in Star. It establishes a paradigm for creating. In order to create a new document, for example, you copy an existing one. Typically, Star users construct blank documents to act as form pad sources for new ones. Making a copy of one of these blank documents is like tearing a sheet off a pad of paper. The ability of users to make their own form pads is one example of the user tailorability built into the system. The show properties command allows you to display and change the properties of an object, such as the name of an icon. We will discuss properties later. In addition to moving, copying, deleting, and showing properties, you can open an icon to see what's inside. You do this by selecting the icon and pushing the open key. The enlarged form is called the window. Every icon has its own window. This is a document window, displaying the contents of a document. Filing is done by moving an icon into or out of a file drawer. These are electronic analogs of the drawers in an office filing cabinet. File drawers are physically stored on file servers connected to the Ethernet. These are local ones stored on file servers in my building in Palo Alto. These are stored on file servers in Los Angeles. You can have as many or as few file drawers on your desktop as you want. Regardless of where they're stored, you interact with them in the same way. When you open a file drawer, it displays a filing window. Each object stored in the file drawer is represented by a miniature icon, a name, and some other information. The names need not be unique or even present. For example, there are two copies of the document named NCC script. The dates tell me which is the latest version. Filing is accomplished by editing filing windows. You can select an object with a mouse and move or copy it out to the desktop. This transfers the object from the file server over the Ethernet to the local disk attached to your Star workstation. You can also move it from the desktop into a file drawer or out of one file drawer and into another for straight server-to-server transfers. Moving deletes the object from its old location. Copying leaves the original behind unchanged. Similarly, there is no print command. Printing is accomplished by moving an object to a printer icon. When you do this, a special window called an option sheet automatically appears. This is a dedicated form-like environment that is widely used in Star to supply arguments to commands or to show properties of objects. Its virtue is that it makes all of the options visible. You don't have to remember what they are. In this case, you can specify the number of copies to print and whether you want the document repaginated before it is printed. Let's print this document and then walk over and pick up the output. As you can see, the screen closely approximates the appearance of a printed page. Mail is delivered to in-baskets. When you open an in-basket icon, a window appears which looks much like a filing window. The fields in the window are mailing related: the recipients of the mail, the date it was sent, who it was from, and the name of the item. Here is a piece of Japanese mail. Notice that any Star document can be sent through the mail.